Escape the room employees. What is the weirdest thing you've seen someone do in one of the rooms? The most depressing shoot I saw was a tired looking couple who brought in their bespectacled NASA shirt wearing 8-year-old geek of a son in to have some fun. The parents couldn't have been more discouraging to him. He was excitedly bouncing around the room pointing out things that he thought were clues, while the parents dismissed every idea he had and told him to stop getting so excited. The parents took charge and proceeded to ignore the obvious clues he was pointing out and spend most of the time pursuing dead ends. Sad part is his instincts were more often than not correct, but his parents just didn't listen and refused to let him explore and try stuff out. Hopefully his curiosity and enthusiasm survives them. Oh wait, I thought of another Anizo we do proposals. Ring in the final puzzle box, proposal signs, whole package deal, people love it. Dude calls up to set up a proposal, I ask what room he wants etc. So then I tell him the total price to book out the entire room for the proposal. He says he just wants to buy the 2 tickets for him and his girlfriend. I tell him we can't have strangers playing a game that their experience is impacted slash altered by the fact that there's a proposal going on. Proposal happens in an escape room. There's no longer a game. It becomes about the proposal. I know this because I've seen it happen 100 times. Anyway, dude refuses to buy out all of the tickets. Says he wants strangers to be there, has not going to buy the other 4 tickets. I hand the phone to my manager, they hash out details together. Over the next 3 weeks leading up to the proposal, this guy calls every single effing day. There's nothing else to figure out, we've got it all set up, but this guy's constantly badgering us. The big day rolls around, he arrives early, so he can hide out, and this dude is a kid. Like, pimple faced, voice cracking, hair growing in weird places kind of kid. Everybody in the control room is talking about him, because he has been a thorn in our collective sides for weeks, and we're speculating about telling him marriage at his age is a horrible idea, but whatever, it's too late. So he hides, the girl and her friends show up, they get started, and we stash the dude in the second hidden room that they'll eventually end up in. Everybody crowds around the monitor to watch, and this guy pulls out a bouquet of flowers and unfurls a sign that says name redacted, will you go with me to prom? And the entire staff loses their collective shoot. Weeks of constant pestering, endless phone calls, and the most stressful proposal deal we've ever put together. For a freaking prom-pizzle. She said no. Just started working at Escape the Room and we have rules about not jumping out the windows and not sticking keys into wall sockets because it has all happened before. Escape room employee here. In one of our rooms, we have an actor pose as a spy and the people in the room had to solve a case to figure out who the traitor was. After they finished the puzzles, it turns out the traitor was actually the spy the actor was playing. The spy then pulls an obviously prop gun, orange tip and whatnot, and the group has to defuse a fake bomb. One of the groups that did this room was a police squad that was doing this to Bond. When the actor pulled the fake gun and said some cheesy lines, the actor was promptly tackled and restrained until the cops realized it was all a game. Edit, it's defuse and not diffuse. Imadang all goofus. Someone cleared all the boxes and locks off of a table in the corner, laid down on it, and went to sleep until the group escaped. I own an escape room and I once guided a couple into one of our more moody ambience room, and they told me we would totally base a 6th dungeon off this vibe. See, you even have a desk in here to get started. Also, you see people's true parenting skills. My favorite quote is from a lovely family that went into a room and 5 minutes in the father gathered his overager children and told them you're being assholes. We're in a huge tech area and we get a lot of corporate groups with some very important people. A week ago we had a Fortune 500 CEO through and he walked up to my staff and started bragging about his 50,000 Instagram followers, basically trying to impress college kids. We definitely giggled about that one, especially when we looked him up, and he had like 300 followers. But hey, he killed it in the room. Escape room employee here. We have a game that has wooden floors and guests regularly try to pull up the nailed down floorboards with a hammer that's in the room, thinking they'll find clues. Also, one time I asked the group if they had ever played an escape game before, and an elderly gentleman responded, "One time my wife tied me up and gagged me. Does that count?" His friends thought it was hilarious, but the high school couple that was obviously on a first date they were paired up with did not find it as funny. Edit. I just remembered another common thing people do. Sometimes halfway through a game, someone that wasn't paying attention will walk up to the entrance, realize it's unlocked, and tell the rest of the group they solved it. Then groupthink sets in and everyone just stands in the hallway as their time runs out. We give people a box for them to bring in, so they can store their belongings while they play. One time, about halfway in, an inquisitive older man started going through their own stuff. He pulled out a purse and shouts, "Guys, guys, I found some. This is our stuff, isn't it?" It was hilarious. For some reason, people like to put the flashlight that one of our rooms has in their mouth when they know they aren't the only ones who have used them. Some people put them between their legs, in the crack of their ass as a joke, and not to mention just roll around the ground a majority of the time. Besides that, I've seen relationships almost fall apart. One couple insisted on going into our most challenging room, just the two of them, and we let them know this was probably not going to be a good idea or enjoyable for them, but they didn't really care. You could tell the guy wanted to impress the girl, but both of them were dumber than rocks. I had to sit for an entire hour watching them get literally nowhere through the first puzzle, arguing with each other, and then sitting in moments of awkward silence. I offered to give them help, and said I would just tell them if they wanted at this point, but they refused. Also, people love to not listen to our disclosure we have to give before we send groups into rooms and kick in our air vents and break through our drywall and ceilings when we specifically say not to, and put tape that says "not a part of the game" in bright yellow colors. It was only a one-off escape room I designed for a university society event, but one guy was so desperate to find clues he tried to disassemble the wooden casing around a radiator. It scared me, because I didn't own the room we were doing this in, so I could have been on serious trouble. Finally, my time to shine. We had a group that was evidently high. They weren't disruptive or anything, so we just briefed them and took them to their room. So far, so good. We have cameras and microphones inside the rooms, that way we know what hints to give out. Another important thing is that the room they were at had a small fountain, and since the particular aesthetic of this room was dusty, that water was filthy. I'm talking murky brown yellow, mud water. At one point, one of the guys says he is thirsty, and proceeds to stick his mouth onto the fountain stream and take a hefty gulp of the shoot water. We spend a second of shock/guffaw, and tell them that drinking the freaking water isn't part of the puzzle. The guy reads the hint and just says that's alright. He proceeded to do the same thing 4 times, and drank the whole fountain, small fountain, but still like a gallon of mud water. We've had more inconvenient things happen, but that still remains as the worst thing I've ever seen. Went to an escape the room with some friends on Friday. My one friend took his shirt off 4 times. The crazier thing that happened though was how we solved it. We were supposed to get the word Waterloo from a series of clues, and use a dictionary to find that the Battle of Waterloo was in 1815. Use that 4-digit number to get a key that let us out of the room. Well, we got the word Eataloo instead of Waterloo. We assumed that it was an anagram and we used a word scrambler to get the word aerolite from it. Using the dictionary, we found that aerolite was invented in 1815. Well, we got the key and we confidently told the employee how we figured it out. He was dumbfounded. I'm not exactly sure what the odds of solving the room like this is, but if someone could solve that for us, that'd be dank. My friends and I have been trying to figure it out since it happened. Did a space station themed room. We got paired with a mother and her adult sons. The sons did just fine, but mom was clueless. There was a prop fire extinguisher on the wall that she was certain had to be for something. For an hour she wandered around aimlessly carrying a fire extinguisher. I worked at a room escape place for a year in grad school. I learned very quickly to give thorough warnings at the start of each show that breaking things, assaulting actors, this was trapped in a room with a zombie, and sexual harassment were not cool. Yes, literally had guys harass the fucking zombie mid-show. Perhaps the most interesting phenomenon I noticed was just how much personality factors into the teamwork involved. I've seen a lot of shy people or people otherwise lacking in confidence be completely on the right track, only to be steamrolled by the loudest, more confident, strongest personalities in the room. Maybe it shouldn't have come as so much of a surprise, but I watched perfectly smart, reasonable people actively ignore good points, logic, and strong evidence in service of a cult of personality of charismatic players. The whole thing felt like a depressing study on group dynamics. Edit, changed hit onto Harris for greater accuracy. I've explained circumstances in follow-up comments. Finally, an AskReddit I can help with. I have too many stories for the escape room I help manage. One situation quickly came to mind when I read this. In our prison style escape room, we have a laser maze that players need to crawl slash climb through to deactivate and move forward. Two players are required to finish all, so I thought the laser maze, because there are three buttons to be pressed, where the third button is out of reach from the other two. A family came in to play our game with a younger boy, a very fit relevant girl in her early 20s, their parents, and their grandfather who had some disability that required him to use those crutches that wrap around your forearms. So they play through and get to the laser maze. The girl got through fairly easily, but they needed to move fast since the timer was running. The young boy had a great idea. Here, use grandpa's crutch. At which point he takes the crutch straight from grandpa and slides it past all the lasers to his sister at the other end. I was fascinated at this point, but even with the crutch it was a long stretch to hit them all. The girl took a second to find the right spot on the floor, planted her foot there, went into a perfect perpendicular stretch with one foot on the ground, one foot on the far button, one hand on the middle button, and finally reaching the last button with the crutch. That family came out of the room so proud, and she boasted to the family about her daily yoga, almost convincing me to sign up for yoga because it was so impressive. That was one of the most creative and weirdest successful solutions to a puzzle I've seen in my years working there. We used to have a giant banana as a mascot, and once we had a group of kids that were intoxicated, and the one of the guys in the room started crying, so we decided to let him hold it. So the guy cuddled with it on the ground and fell asleep about 10 minutes into the game. Had the time of his life. Like most rooms, we have cameras all throughout the game, so we can keep any eye on players, give hints based on what puzzle they're on, and watch out for any shenanigans. So ours is a prison themed escape. At one point there are three cells that need to be opened in order. One of them has a live actor in it that messes with you the entire time, even after you rescue him. Anyway, each cell is pretty much the same, with a toilet, shelf, and a few other items. One guy was pretty drunk and repeatedly put bones and other shit in his pants to get a laugh out of his teammates, but they stopped paying attention to him while trying to actually make their escape. He must have gotten bored being so drunk and not caring about the escape room. He leaves the main group and heads back to his prison cell area. Him watching on the cameras and see has not with the rest of the group. So I start clicking around trying to find him. Sure enough, has in a jail cell hovering over a toilet, taking a piss. There's no plumbing. They're definitely just props. We shut their game down on the spot. His group was not happy with him at all. After they left, I had the pleasure of soaking up his piss with a mop little by little, and it was after that night we added the anyone visibly intoxicated will not be allowed to participate rule. Started working in an escape room around 3 months ago. This is not really a weird thing, but more acute one. One day a dude called and told us he was proposing to his girlfriend and that they were both huge fans of escape rooms. So my boss and came up with a cool idea how we could change our escape room to make it more romantic, and that at the end of the escape they wouldn't find the key of the room, but the ring and a bottle of champagne. We also told the dude the solutions of some of the puzzles to make sure they would actually come to the end of the room. It was the cutest thing I have ever seen, the way these two worked together in the room, and how excited the dude was when they found the ring and the champagne at the end and he asked to marry her. They were both in tears, so were my boss and I. She said yes. After that they stayed with us for a bit before heading their own way. It is still one of my favorite evenings and one of the reasons I love my newfound job so much. actual escape room employee here. The weirdest thing I saw was a young couple in our hardest room. They asked for our hardest, who when they cold and solved our puzzles took off their shoes and just sat down and talked. When I would send them hints to get them to start playing again, the lady would call me a commie. It was weird. For example, the lady would pick up a red clue paper that goes with a pyramid puzzle. They would stare at it, then put it to the side. I type in a hint, the red papers go with the pyramid. She looks up the screen. We were getting to that. Commie, I'm not a communist, and the room isn't communist themed in the slightest. I currently work at an escape room. We had a youth group come in and play some rooms, and halfway in we smell this horrendous smell. Our control room is right next to the room. When we got them out, we noticed they built a little tent, and inside was two giant mounds of shoot. Kid took a shoot in the room, and we approached the adults and said, oh, that wasn't us, we thought you put that in there. So they denied it, even though the kid had brown stains down the back of his pants. Our owners called, they confessed, and we deep cleaned the room while they got charged for it. Great times. Obligatory, not an employee, but I'm sure my friend group looked pretty weird to them. We did the one where you get stuck in handcuffs and have to unlock them, but we couldn't get the key to work on one of my friends. We assumed that there was another key to get the last person for some reason, and left her attached to the wall for like 20 minutes. Turns out her cuffs were broken, and we had to pause the game so the employees could come get her out with bolt cutters. They were shocked that we'd just left her there, but we thought it was part of it. One time I did an escape room with some people from work. The final clue was, what time does Bible study meet? And a 4-digit combo lock. After we couldn't find any useful clues, I just went over to the lock and put in 0600, 0615, etc. It opened at 0700. Apparently we were supposed to look out the window to where the church across the street had their schedule printed on a big sign. According to the attendant, nobody had ever tried that before. I don't work at Escape the Room. I work at Breakout Games, but it's the same deal. I had a couple in a handcuffed slash blindfolded room start feeling each other up until I said over the microphone, just a reminder that I can see you guys from 4 cameras in the room. If you need any hints, let me know. Edit. Additional story, we had a customer try to put his finger in an outlet because he thought a key was in it. That isn't his fault, because there are rooms that do this, but I was scared half to death. I don't understand why any escape room would put anything important in a place that normally is a hazard. Actual escape room employee here. One couple couldn't agree on how to solve the puzzles and broke up inside the room. Another couple had the guy surprise the girl with a proposal. Another couple got a horror themed escape room and just sat on the floor and cuddled. They didn't look scared. They didn't bother to solve anything either. They just cuddled with all the creepy props and sound effects surrounding them. I guess they couldn't find a creepy motel to cuddle in. Question mark? Actually work in an escape room, but this one happened to my colleague. We have this false door who leads to a wall, which is to make people believe that's the way they came in here blindfolded at first. One guy was so happy that he found the last key in a record time that when he opened the door, he slammed his head so hard that the group in the next room got scared.